Yeah, this DJ Paul, the king of Memphis, representing that Three C's Mafia, killing the streets, bitch!
Yeah! For the first time, it's going down history, baby. New Three C's Mafia, featuring A-Ball, NimJG, Young Buck. It's a Tennessee thing. We gotta stay.
Niggas love. Oh, man. Yeah, I know. $100 tip. Oh, hell no. He can still be thankful. I'm cool.
The real purple. You can't buy those in that liquor store. And Fanta ain't responsible for none of this, so don't think it.
Y'all gonna see, man. This video gonna be bananas, man. All Tennessee, man. Tennessee, man. Stick together, baby. Ain't nothing to happen, man.
Everybody, the whole South sticking together. State to state, individually, Atlanta putting their thing down by sticking together. Tennessee, we here now, baby, so we pulling ours all together. And as the South, we representing as one. And do it like that. You know, Tennessee, I mean, we only got a handful of us that's just out there. We got a lot of local independent artists out here doing their thing. The soon to come will be right here too. But up until then, man, if we got that shot and that light, man, we out here pulling it all together. Paul did that, so don't keep looking at me. Let me do it. Right.
I didn't do nothing, man.
Yeah, I did a single off 3-6 Mafia album, man. It was like more of an honor of me being on the record. You understand? It's me, not only 666, but 8-Ball and MJG, them legends of the South. You understand? They put it down.
Leave your drink around me, believe your drink gon' get drunk up,
nigga. Your shit gon' get swallowed, motherfucker. So
we got a new thing, you can come get your goddamn freeze cup in the hood. Get your syrup freeze cup.
Look at the color and the light right there, man. So delicious. Smoke free, baby.
Play my part,
man. What? Work with it.
Stay real.
Stay real. You know, that's the whole shit. Kid Kabuda right there with a nigga. Stay real, man. And, man, stick with a nigga, man. We've been doing this for a long time. I think we was kids, nigga. A long time. You know what I'm talking about?
I keep telling the world, man, I had $1 million and my mama was still living in the project. Straight up. I said, mama, why you won't leave? She said, I don't want to. So I knew then, it's in my blood. It got a little crazy though. Too many CDs on the front porch. She hit me up and said, I gotta go. Yeah. So she big now.
That's how all moms in the South is though.
Yeah, man.
I talked to Baby, Master P, everybody. All moms in the South, they don't really be wanting to leave the house. That was the family house. Grandmama said that I stayed there, said I passed it down, everybody that stayed there, they don't be wanting to leave. But like, that's how I was, man. My mama, man, niggas bringing demos over there all the time, like 3-4 in the morning. I just bagged the U-Haul truck up to them thing. I said, look, you finna get the hell up out of here.
You can
keep this house, you can still own it if you want to, and come back whenever you want to. But you ain't finna spend the night in this motherfucker.
I'ma tell y'all what 50 told me to tell y'all. G-Unit hypnotized mind, respect it and check it, or get stripped butt naked.
Yeah, it's going down. Right behind us right here is the house where I grew up in Black Haven Zone, you know what I'm saying? That's where it all started for us. Juicy J was doing his thing at his folks' house on the north side of town, and I was doing my thing right here at my folks' house. This is where my mom, my dad lived, me, a couple of my brothers and all that. And Lord Infamous, all of us just up in here doing the thing. I met Juicy, he started coming over here, and we just formed 3-6 Mafia. Formed 666 Mafia, rather. Right up out of that house, right there, you know what I'm saying?
Everybody say, you like Jazzy Jeff? I used to love it. Like, whoa! I'm a DJ, man. I'm supposed to look a little bit like Jazzy.
That's the house. We ran our DJ service out of my man D-Magic, Danny Jackson. We used to be in that house right there. That's a lot of memories right there. That hill, you know what I'm saying? All the drug dealers used to stand on that hill. You know what I'm saying? That's a lot of memories right there. I mean, that's where Juicy J started his career, right there, right in that house right there.
a partner of mine named Vasco introduced me to D Magic. He's like, man, I know a nigga that got a lot of DJ equipment, man. You know what I'm saying? A lot of DJ equipment. And he was like, man, we need to get in there, you know, do something, put something down. So when he introduced me to Danny, his rap name was, DJ name was D Magic. I went in, you know, went in his house, and he was like, man, you know, I think I was like 14. Little ass nigga. He like, man, you know, I heard you, you know, you can cut up and shit. I heard you cold on the turntables. So he set the shit up for me. He hit the big speakers. And I was just scratching. He was like, man, damn, man, shit. I ain't never seen a motherfucker scratch like that. So he was like, he like, man, we need to start a DJ business. You know what I'm saying? We'll, you know, I set the equipment up. And you DJ the parties, and we'll just split the money down the middle. And I was like, shit, cool.
Man, back in the day, man, for DJing, I wasn't really out DJing like that, like, cause I didn't really want to be a DJ. But once I got the equipment, I had to do something to learn how to use the equipment. So I just started making a little mixtapes just to learn how to use the equipment. But I was really making the mixtapes to try to blow up out rapping, just trying to promote that. This is the high school right here. This is the school right here, baby. Hillcrest High School, the Viking. The Mighty Vikings, man. Right there. You know what I'm saying?
Paul was DJing on the south side of town. I was DJing on the north side of town. And this dude that introduced us to, because the guy that we was working with, both of us knew him. He like, hey, man, I'm going to introduce you to DJ Paul. And DJ Paul introduced you to Juicy J. And it's been like history ever since.
This is 3-6 Mafia documentary. I'm Crump. We had old school Sundays at Census, the best club in Memphis. And I'm about to tell y'all how I put DJ Paul and Juicy J on the map. It was way back in the day. It was about 90, 92, 91. I met DJ Paul through a local celebrity, the first rapper that ever made it out of Memphis. His name is Gangsta Pat. I met DJ Paul. He was in a group with his brother, Lord Infamous. It was called Serial Killers. I used to let them niggas record in my house. And I'm gonna tell you, I went away to Florida, Orlando for about 2 years, 93, 95. I came back in 95. DJ Paul, Juicy J, them niggas had a vision. But here's the story. They came to my house, 95, on some how can we take over the world shit. And we all put a plan together. Which it was orchestrated by DJ Paul and Juicy J. Don't let me forget that shit. They did it all.
Paul had a couple of people he was working with, like Lord Infamous and Crunchy Black, you know what I'm saying? I was working with Project Pat and some more people. You know, we just brought all the rappers he was producing, all the rappers I was producing, just brought them together and made Hypnotized Minds. And Triple Six Mafia actually was like a clique name. It was like a bunch of us, you know what I'm saying? It was a bunch of people. And we had to kick this person out and kick that one out and kick this one out and fuck this motherfucker out and narrow it down to, you know, a nice size.
Yo, what's up? Y'all right with your boy Crunch and Black doing this documentary once again, you feel what I'm saying? But this time I'm gonna take it to the BAZ side, you know what I'm saying? Where we pimp rides at Exotic Customs, you know what I'm saying, my big brother. Down they got a little shop, you know, he chopping them up, you know, doing whatever you really want, you know. We got our boys spraying on the back of your car, just like L.A., man. I told you, we just like L.A., man, you know what I'm saying? We just a baby L.A., man. And with these cars and with chopping them up and with putting them together, man, we doing it like real big, man. You know what that is, good time, but we had a good time. Bill Street, you know what I'm saying? B.B. King. All the good stuff, man, all the good stuff.
When it was like the first 3-6 Mafia, you know, the guys who was with us at first, it wasn't no love there. It wasn't no respect. Everybody wanted to be Paul and Juicy. You know, you got to be an artist. They the producers. So, you know, it really messed it up. But, you know, this new clique we got, you know, Fraser, Lil White, Chrome, Boogerman, you know, Project Pat, all the new guys and all the old guys that have been here, it ain't no breaking.
Yeah, everybody used to always think 666 Mafia was devil worshipers. But we won, though. It was just like a name that we just kind of came up with. My brother Lord Infamous came up with it. He was just saying it in a rap, and he said 666 Mafia. And then I was like, that'll be cool. That'll be a cool name for our rap group. And they was like, yeah, and we named it the rap group, and it was just a name. It wasn't really nothing. no code or nothing behind it, though. We just liked it. We just thought it was cool. Once again, we were young.
I think that was just because we call ourselves 666 Mafia, and that was like 666. A lot of things we put 666 down and then showed our pictures. But, you know, I'm with God 100%.